Hi everyone, download beginning Linux programming 4th edition book from the Google. So once in the Google you are type like this, maybe first link you can able to find out the PDF file. In this book we are going to first focusing on chapter number 3, that is working with files. In your home folder create a LSP directory. I think everyone see my home folder LSP directory is there. Here I am going to write a program. First of all, I am going to write down Hello World application programming. Hello.c. So if you want to write a Hello World application programming, definitely you need a header file. So that is a stdio.h and main function. So the best programmer to return a value of the main function, the success is 0, so the main should be return value. So that is the best way to write the programming model. So these are very clearly we can understand Hello World application programming. Do you know how to test this programming also? How to test program? First compile the code, binary file generated. Okay, I create a binary file name with a defined name, okay, hello_app. Okay, now run the binary file _app. Now you can see the result hello world. Now I am going to explain about Hello World system programming. The file name is hello_sys.c. Sys indicate system programming. So system programming, we also write the C programming language. So the C programming main is essential function. So it decide where the program beginning, ending. The concept should be same, and main should return integer and return value 0, correct. So what is application programming? Write a program using library, example printf. Every library behind system call is there. What is system programming? Writing a program using system calls. The printf behind write system call, scanf behind read system call. So now we are going to use the system programming. Okay, what a program name? Hello World system programming. Hello World system programming. The Hello World system programming, here we don't use library, here use system call. The system call name is write. But how to use the write system call? I think you want to study write system call arguments, what return value, how to use it now. So because of this, in the Linux all the system calls man pages are available. I am going to open one more terminal. You can see here, you can, so Linux all the help information provide in the form of man pages only. I think you know man pages have some levels now. Level 1 user commands, level 2 only system calls, any system call information level 2, level 3 only for library, like that up to 9 levels are available. Right now we are focusing on system call number 2, that's why man 2. System call name, which one I am going to study? Right, the syntax now. Man level number, system call level number 2. In case library, level number 3. In case command, level number 1. Command by default, level number is not required. Okay, So now I want to study about right system call, help information. I'm the beginner. I want to implement right system call. So then man page better source. Man to right. Enter. So now you can see here clear. Here 2 indicate system call number. Man page level number 2 indicate here. So next to right system call definition. What is the right system call definition? Write to a file descriptor. File descriptor is on a unsigned integer that can corresponding to the file. Every file it consisting of file descriptor. Do you know? I think you know. In Linux, everything is a file. The meaning of everything divided also. Keyword is a file, mount is a file, like that. Zero is a keyword, Linux pointer, file descriptor number zero. It is can point out the corresponding file. In Linux, everything is a file. Zero indicate keyboard, device is a file. One indicate monitor, standard output is a file. I told Linux basics time. Standard I/O redirection pipes. Basically, standard input the keyboard the number 0, standard output monitor the number 1, standard error also monitor is point out the error number 2. 0, 1, 2, they are called file descriptors now. 0 is a keyboard, 1 is a monitor, 2 also monitor, but the way of printing is a error now. Just now I told 3 file descriptor. So ultimately what I'm saying, every program by default consists of 3 file descriptor. Those are 0, 1, 2. 0 is a standard input, nothing but keyboard. 1 is a monitor, normal output. 2 is a monitor, error output. Now come back to the system call syntax. Write system call first argument file descriptor, the integer number. You write the monitor, first argument should be 1. If you write the error type of information, first argument is a 2, like that now. Second argument is a constant void buffer. Read only buffer. The data, how much data we are going to write down here. The void pointer, you can pass any data type here now. So for example, hello world is a buffer, hello world. I want print monitor hello world. Okay. Third argument is a count, how many number of bytes in the buffer. Side underscore t represent unsigned integer. You can see here also. S side underscore t represent signed integer. S indicate signed integer. No. In Linux kernel, S underscore T and S underscore T, they are called user defined data types. Linux kernel understand easy. This meaning is a unsigned integer, this meaning is a unsigned integer. Last argument is a unsigned count. Write system call return value is a signed integer return value. So now the description given clearly what a write system call also. One more point, write system call return value. Write system call success, very clear, on success, this system call success, number of bytes return. For example, last argument 13 bytes I mentioned, write system call successfully return 13 bytes, return is a 13 bytes only, positive integer number return. Write system call success, return positive integer number. In case write system call fail, -1, very clear, error, -1 nothing but error number. So that's why write system call return success time positive integer number, failure time -1. Write system call also return a 0 that indicate nothing was written. The system call not fail, unable to return. No. Maybe there no space in the buffer, like that. No. In case write system call fail, it returns some error number. The all errors now. The all are the errors now. I will tell you some example of errors like a bad file descriptor, wrong file descriptor is given, some permission denied, like some type of errors are coming now, some errors now. Now go back, write the program now. So now if you want by using a write system call, the write system call function declaration, side underscore t, SS underscore t, user defined data types, all are declared in the this header file now. So the header file you can use, the header file name UNISCD, Unix standard. Linux all the system calls are implemented based on Unix platform. So the name traditional word UNISCD.h. Okay, first of all you can use the header file. What is the header file? We are going right in the monitor now. That's why you can put the value 1. Because you know, first argument file descriptor. So we write the monitor nothing but 1. 1 monitor. Normal output. 2 is a monitor only but error now. Second argument buffer. The buffer is a hello world. So last argument, how many number of. So now I am going to save the program and compile the code. Compile a program exactly same like a compilation of application. The binary file name is user defined name hello underscore sys. So now output hello underscore sys generated. Now execute the binary file. So the same result is coming. What is the application program result? Same is a system program result also coming. Now we are going to discussing about read system call. The scanf library behind read system call is implemented. Read system call definition. Read from a file descriptor. Every program by default 3 file descriptor, that is 0, 1, 2. 0 indicates standard keyboard. 1 indicates monitor, that is normal output. 2 indicates error output. So now using read system call, first argument file descriptor. So the obviously if you want read from the keyboard, the file descriptor should be 0. Second argument is a buffer. Whenever read system call success, second argument will get the data. How many number of bytes you want read, you can tell about the third argument. Last argument is a read system call return value. Read system call basically 3 different kind of values are written. Success nothing but number of bytes written, that is positive integer number written. For example, count I mentioned 6. Read system call read 6 bytes of data, return value 6 only. One more value 0 also written. Whenever read system call return 0 indicate end of the file. The file last location we can unable to read now. Read system call one more value return minus 1. The minus 1 indicate error. Error also. Total it can return 3 different kind of values only. Now coming to the program, we have read.c is a one file. So now you can see in this program I can declare local buffer 100. So RET is integer variable. So now read system call first argument 0 indicates standard keyboard. So the buffer I am expecting to read 6 bytes of data from the keyboard. So now read system call waiting for 6 bytes of data from keyboard. So whenever user is enter 6 bytes of data is in accepted. In case more than that enter, but it can take it only 6 bytes only. Remaining bytes it cannot accept. Read system call return value. In case 0 return, the meaning end of the file. In case 6 return, how many number of bytes we are expected, the number of bytes we are reading, the data stored in the buffer we are going to print into the percent register. Now we are going to execute this program. So read nothing but scanf. Okay, scanf generally is waiting for until end of the file. Read also waiting for minimum 6 bytes of data. Minimum 6, not like a length. Your count exactly 6 bytes only waiting for the data from the standard keyboard. 0 is a keyboard. Now if you run this program, so whenever run this program, behind read system call in working, nothing but scanner. Scanner also waiting something from the keyboard, read also waiting for the keyboard. Now I am going to enter some data. Enter some data like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bytes enter. So read system call read 6 bytes of data and showing also. In case I am enter less than 6 bytes, it cannot read also, because read expecting minimum 6 bytes of data. In case I can enter more than the 6 bytes of data, read can accept 6 bytes only, remaining but ignore it. In case you press Ctrl D, press Ctrl D, the meaning of Ctrl D, end of the file. Now I am going to press Ctrl D, is the end of the file, Ctrl D. So like that read system call working principle, you study how it works.